Do you know why we have come for the night vigil?
To
learn. For healing.
To learn.
For blessing.
No.
To learn God's ways. And I want to tell you, every time you learn something, enemy wants to steal that word. And when he comes to steal that word, it gives you and me a beautiful opportunity, because the test has just begun. And now, what we are learning, we are saying to the Holy Spirit, come on, Holy Spirit, teach me how to apply it. I want to learn. And might be you missed it. Have you ever seen, today there was a brother who came to drop me to Sarja, okay? So he did not know the way, so he had put the GPS. And he would miss a turn. And he said, brother, I just missed the turn. I said, now are you going to turn back? He said, no, wait, just wait. And the GPS began to show him another route. So I said, is this route still going to take us to Sarja? He said, yes. But is it going to be the short way? He said, no, it's going to be a little long, but we'll still reach the destination. And I said, that's exactly what God is saying. Even if you miss the mark, that doesn't mean you miss the destination forever. You miss the mark, repent, start it all over again. And this time, be extremely vigilant that when he gives you an instruction, take a turn, you take a turn. Today's instruction for us is, no matter what happens, Lord, I'm going to praise you.
Praise God.
Even if I don't feel like, but I'm going to praise you. And when we follow those instructions, it's like a GPS leading you to your destination. It looks, if you don't know the way, it looks as if you are going roundabout in the city. Because every route is new to you. But if you keep on following it and following it and following it, there comes a place where you say, ah, now I know from here. So if I use GPS to go to Nas house, when I come to the circle there, I know the way from there. And doctor, your place, when I come to the parking, I know it, your place. Because your place, every time I come sleeping and I go also sleeping. Hallelujah. So what does he say? Those things which you have both learned
and seen in me, do.
Which one do we put more priority?
Pray.
And what is the word of God saying?
Do.
So do I need to pray?
No. You need to do.
You need to pray so that you get the strength to do. Praying is like you're filling your fuel tank and then you can drive the car. If you don't pray, there's no fuel in your car. Now, you can have a fuel and you can still go on the wrong side. But when you have the fuel and you follow the instructions, now you have the power to go in the right direction. So what does he say?
Do.
Heard and seen in me. Do. And only when you do, what will happen?
And the God of peace.
Isn't that beautiful?
Yes.
So when will the peace of God be with you?
When you be the doer of the word of God. When you are the doer of the word.
Hey, y'all are missing. I asked a question, when will the peace of God be with you?
When you pray.
And you do these things.
You forgot.
Those things which are.
This is God of peace. But what I'm asking you is, when will the peace of God be with you?
Rejoice.
When you do all these things. When you do all these things.
And you walk in love.
That's 7th verse, brother.
Rejoice.
6th verse. Yeah, now read it.
Be careful for nothing, but in everything by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving.
So you are doing theory over here. Hello, you are doing theory over here of mind. Praying, rejoicing, all that is theory that you are doing. God of peace will be with you. But now you are going into action, verse number 9.
Yes.
Are you following?
Yes.
So first comes the peace of God. And with the peace of God, when you start doing what the instructions in the Bible are saying, now God of peace will be with you. So even though God says, Jesus says, I am with you, I will not leave you, I will not forsake you, I am with you till the end of time. Yes, Jesus is with me, but am I with Jesus? I will be with Jesus and Jesus with me when I am a doer of the word of God. Praise God.
Praise God.
So from now on, are we going to rejoice?
Yes.
Are we going to still complain and grumble and be bitter and be offended? A mood off? You know what? The next day, the wife was sitting in the car and we were going to Bandra for the retreat. This man was driving the car. So I asked her, yesterday night, what time did your husband come? She said at 1:30. I said, okay. Did he say anything to you? She said, no. I asked him, how was the retreat? He said, it was very good, and he went off to sleep. So I began to realize he was very tired. Then I asked her, did you ask him in the morning? She said, yes, I asked him, but he said it was good. That's all he said. Then I told her the whole story. And she started clapping her hand. And she said, brother, honestly speaking, this is the best retreat. Now, every time he gets bugged up, all I have to do is say, Mahabaleshwar. So, see, we got to, there are weaknesses of different people. Okay? So, we got to help the other person to remind him of the word. See, most of the time we take a wrong decision or a wrong action because we fail to remember. Okay? Remember what? God's instruction. And only when we have fallen, then we say, oh God, I should have done that. Has it happened?
Yes.
Yeah. So our loved ones should not point finger, but our loved ones should be there to remind one another of the instructions. Like, I did not accuse them, but I said, in a situation like this, I'm going to follow this instruction. Are you all with me? And when they understood the instruction, they were quick to renew their mind and follow the instruction. Now the whole atmosphere in the car, when we were coming 240 kilometers, was full mood. And then each one was saying, brother, if I had to do this, how much of situations I would have avoided in my marriage, in my workplace, in my business, in so many things. How many of you believe that? If we had to keep our mouth shut, so many things would have been better for us.
Yes.
Yeah?
Yes.
In spite of knowing that, we still open our mouth.
Yes.
Yes.
So we got to what?
Learn.
We got to what?
Learn.
Because the devil will instigate us. He will put thoughts up the thoughts and say, see, listen, if you keep quiet, that person is taking advantage of you. You'll surely get this thought. That person is taking advantage of you. If you are a Christian, then every person in this world is supposed to take advantage of you. Hello. Are you listening?
Yes. Yes.
Okay, tell me one thing. What is my advantage by coming here?
Influence.
I have to stay awake the whole night?
To learn.
Spend my own money to take a flight ticket. Correct? And while going, no reals back. So what's the advantage? Am I not giving you advantage? You will be going and sleeping. I will not be sleeping. I will be taking a flight to go to Abu Dhabi. Correct? So I realized that I am taking so much of advantage from Jesus. And Jesus is giving.
Yes.
So if I am a Christian, then people are supposed to take advantage of me. And I am supposed to allow them to take advantage. Then it's love. Nobody liked it long.
Yes.
Most of the time, when we want to do something, what's the first thing? What's my advantage? Sariya?
Yes.
Hello, Sariya?
Sariya.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So from now on, will you look at your advantage?
No.
Sure?
Yes.
All husbands will be calling me now. They'll say, brother, of all the night vigil, this was the best night vigil. What did you preach? After coming home, she's so cool. Even if I put my finger in her mouth, she doesn't bite. No biting now. No teeth, brother. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
So, are we going to look at the answers in the Bible?
Yes.
Second point. Pain forces me to lean on the arm of God instead of man. Most of the time, where do you want to lean on? When I'm in a situation, whom do I pick up the call? Oh, I pick up the call and call of whom?
Mama.
Those were the old days. Now you never call up. Those were the time when you did not know. Okay? Now that you began to understand the scriptures and the instructions, I don't think so I ever got a single call after that. That doesn't mean that you don't have situations, but now you have begin to lean on God. Praise God.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
See, we always like to lean on people. And as long as you are depending on people, you will never be able to experience God. When you lean on God, God will bring people in your life who will help you to come out of your situation. I always say, when God has to do something in my life, He will do through relationship. When Satan wants to do something in my life, He will do through relationship. But in all these things, where am I leaning on? There are so many testimonies in the Bible of people who relied on God. Let's take for example King Joseph. He knows those three kings are going to kill him. He knows without a doubt. He is full of fear. But then what does he do? He begins to encourage himself. He begins to edify himself and relies on God. Now when he began to rely on God, did God do supernatural things? The three kings were killed. King Jehoshaphat and the people became millionaires. But before that, he had to rely on God. And how did he rely on God? A message that was spoken to him, that the battle belongs to God. Praise God.
Praise God.
So in our day-to-day life, do I really lean on God's word? You know, the best part in this spiritual life is, when it comes to anything physical of the world, I have to show them evidence, the physical evidence. But when it comes to God, it's not the physical evidence, that we depend on. It's the spiritual evidence that we depend on. Not the evidence that you can see, but the evidence that you can't see, which is recorded in the Bible. So the more and more we learn to depend on the things that are declared in the Bible, but you cannot sense it with your senses. When we begin to learn to lean on those things, that's when we see the supernatural hand of God. If you are a person who is only stepping out when you see all things are in your favor, and you are using your reasoning and all those things, and you are stepping out, you won't see results. Like Peter, when he heard the word come, every one of them was, we know that when we step into the water, we sink. All his life he knew that every time he went fishing, his legs went into the water. But when Jesus said that word, come, Peter just believed that word and stepped out in faith. Now, how many of us in the midst of pain make a strong decision to rely on God's word and step out in faith and depend on that? Those are the ones who really see the hand of God. And once you begin to learn to rely on God, now you are no longer depending on people. 16 years back, when I lost everything in life and God began to teach me, he showed me a beautiful principle, and the principle was to give. He taught me that when you give, it will multiply and come back to you. Now, in the natural, it looks the most foolish thing, because all our life we have learned that if you have got 10 marbles, you give 7, the answer is 3, which you can see. And here is God teaching me that, son, when you have 10 marbles and you have given 7 for my kingdom, I will multiply that 7 and the result is 700. Okay? When he began to teach me, I had to step out in faith. You know, in my early days, when I started working, I never totaled up 10%. Okay? My way of giving was that if I could hear the Lord saying, empty your purse, no matter how much money is there, I would just empty. And it went on and on and on. And in no time I saw the multiplication, that 16 years have gone by, it's just multiplying. So I began to rely in this area of relying on God. Are you following?
Yes.
So there are different areas. This area of mine, when it comes to finance, extremely strong. But might be in other areas, I might be weak. So we got to learn to be strong in every area. Might be somebody else, when it comes to money, that person might be extremely weak. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Is it easy to rely on God when it comes to money? And that too every month. And I am so amazed that 16 years have gone by depending on God to pay all our bills. And it's so amazing that month after month he pays all our bills. Can I ask you a question? In Oman, if I want to bring the CDs from India, am I allowed to bring the CDs? Under any license? So how does the church bring? For the bookstore, they must be bringing a big quantity, right? Now this is my desire that God has put in my life, to make about 40 to 50,000 of Suwar and the Seed CD and bring it to Dubai and distribute during the mass, asking the priest for permission. Because the CDs that we give to people are those who are already caught. But the ones who come for Sunday Mass, they have never tasted God's word. So now our desire is to spend more and more money to make CDs and distribute them during the Mass. And let's say we distributed 30,000, out of that 300 heard it. Praise our Sutra. So yeah, from here 2 days I've been talking to people, because here in Dubai they do not have CD manufacturing. They have only have CD burning. So by the time they burn the CD, it's 18 rupees. And by the time we get in India, it's 8 rupees. The full CD ready. So if I am a steward of God's kingdom, I would like to use the money in such a way that I get maximum output. So if you know how to get into the country, let's get it into country and distribute this CD so that simple people who hear it, their lives are changed. How many of you believe listening to the CD can really change people's lives?
Yes.
Supposing all of us who put the hands up start using some reals and start multiplying and start giving the CDs out in a small way, can we make an impact?
Yes.
Or are we the people who only want to come for the night vigil and sing praise the Lord and do nothing? If I were truly a Christian, then I'm asking God, God, I've got so many years to live. Before I leave this planet Earth, what can I do for you? How can I establish your kingdom and spread your kingdom on this earth? Then I'm a Christian. Then I'm truly in love with Jesus. Because when you are in love with Jesus, you are only looking at other people's benefit. You are looking at how can people take advantage of you. And that advantage that they take brings conversion in their life. Praise God.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So are we going to rely on God's arms?
Yes.
Third one. Faith forces me to learn. When will I learn? I know some people. Where to learn? See, in our team, when somebody wants to help us, then before they can help us, they have to learn scriptures by heart. Okay? So, if a person wants to come and, you know, somebody came and did the construction for us and the labor was free, but before he could do that, he had to learn the scriptures. Somebody wanted to give us a car, and I still remember he had to learn the scriptures, and he was at Bombay Marine Lines Chopati with the scriptures in his hand, walking on the beach, learning the scriptures so that he could give the car. Are you following what I'm saying?
Yes, brother.
Because only when you learn the scriptures by heart, that scriptures will teach you where you're going wrong. Now, many a times people get offended because when they want to help us, they say, that's not your concern. Why are you asking us to learn the scriptures by heart? I'll tell you, this happened 3 months back. Our expenses had increased and we were 20 lakhs on a minus side. Okay? And our brother Alred was dropping me to the airport, and in the car, he just told me, because I don't look into the finance. Okay? So he told me, brother, we are 20 lakhs short and we need at least 5 lakhs to give to some of the suppliers because we have not been able to pay them. So I said, what do I do? So he looked at me and I said, do you want me to go and tell people that we need money? I'll do that if you want me to. But all this time we did not do. So he looked at me and then he said, "Hey, brother, I'm sorry. I've doubted God." And he made a prayer and I came to Dubai. So among the team members, there was a discussion going on because now we have two rehabs in Sri Lanka and a new home which has been constructed for prostitutes. So they said, why does brother have to take the money and pay their bills first instead of paying our bills first? Are you listening?
Yes.
And a big amount is for the widows. Okay? So why is the ministry looking after the widows every month? They can do it once in a while. And I and brother, Alred, we both started to cry and we said, we can't stop them. So it was, I was in the hall in the church and the praise and worship was going on, the last song was going on, and a man comes. He has got sandals on his feet, just like yours. Okay? Just the sandals. Simple man. And he comes with a letter and says to Alred, this is my testimony. So Alred says, okay. And then he says, God spoke to me 4 months back to give you 10 lakhs. Okay? So Alred said, what did you say? God spoke to me 4 months back to give you 10 lakhs. And that was the time from when there was minus going on. So Alred began to cry. He called me and we said, God, this morning, there was a discussion that I'm not supposed to take the money to Sri Lanka. I'm not supposed to do this. I'm not supposed to do that. And God, you saw our heart that we said, God, no matter what happens, we are going to lean on you. We are going to depend on you. And praise be to God. Today we are not on minus, we are on plus. So God saw us. That are you still going to follow under pressure? Or are you going to follow the world system? Under pressure is where we go astray. Yeah?
Yes.
And especially when we are in pain, we want to do something that will release us from this uncomfort. And we might take a step that might be extremely easy. But when you still follow the instruction, even in that pain, now you will see results.
Praise God.
And this man said in his testimony, brother, I was living an extremely, extremely sinful life. And he mentioned everything in that testimony. And he said, it's been 3 years that I've been listening to the CD. And in these 3 years, everything has changed. And then Alred spoke to him and said, listen, you've got to learn the scriptures by heart. He said, I've not only learned those scriptures, I've learned even the thanksgiving, all those scriptures by heart.
Praise God.
Because I've seen what the scriptures have done. My marriage is blessed, my children are blessed. So we asked him, what business do you do? He said, I'm not a businessman. I'm on a salary. But I was on a very small position. The scriptures, after I started learning, the scriptures have given me promotion after promotion, and I'm now the top in the company.
Praise God.
So learning the scriptures, many people will say, you know, I've got a weak memory. How come you can remember riyals correctly? Certain things our memories are very sharp. Okay, let's close our eyes. Let's pray to God and talk to Him. All this time, when we went through pain, we allowed pain to have a hold on us. instead of looking to the Word of God for answers, we began to operate through the world system that we learned in this world. Instead of relying and leaning on God's arm, we were leaning on men's arm. Instead of looking at the Word of God as a mirror and learning from God where we have gone wrong and making the necessary corrections, we have allowed error to continue in our life. My friend, you might be seeking God and saying, God, I need this miracle and I'm desperate for it. Tonight God is saying that every time we disobey God, that act of disobedience takes us further away from the blessings, from the miracles that we are seeking for, and leads us into a curse. And every act of obedience in the midst of pain and pressures of life draws us closer and closer to the blessings of God and the miracles of God. So tonight, God is speaking to each one of us to be extremely vigilant. We can master over the pain using God's word. And if we do not agree to God's word, then pain will master over us and destroy us. Pain has the capacity to lead us into depression and cause death in our life. But the word of God has the power to empower us not only to overcome pain, but to keep ourselves always victorious in the midst of pain. So speak to the Lord. For example, I had a cough right now. I wanted to speak, but there was an irritation, there was a choke in my throat. And I know that the solution would be a sip of water. And the moment I had that sip of water, the choke was gone, the throat was cleared, and I'm able to continue. In the same way, in our everyday life, pressures come to choke us. And the word of God is that living water that flows from our heart. But this water will flow only when we agree to God's word, when we believe in God's word, when we act on God's word. This living water will destroy every choke of life. And life will begin to flow in our lives. The God kind of life in abundance in our life. So let us learn to drink of this water every day, every night, and experience God's relationship, God's fellowship, God's intimacy in our everyday life. We thank you, we praise you, Father, for teaching us these truths. In Jesus' name.
Amen. Amen. Amen.